Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this brief screencast on stock split and stock dividend. Let us assume a little information. The current outstanding shares are 400,000 for a company, and the price per share is $50 per share. That means the current market value of the company's equity is going to be 400,000 times 50, and that will give us $20 million. Now the company decides to go for a 5-for-2 stock split. It means that for every 2 shares that we hold now, we are going to have 5 shares. Now therefore, the new number of shares after the stock split, let me give you a little tip here to find that out quickly. What you need to do is you are going to pick up the current outstanding share, that is 400,000 here. So let us write here 400,000. And what we are going to do is we are going to simply multiply this 400,000 by a ratio between new shares to old shares. So after the stock split is completed, you are going to have 5 shares. So that is the new number of shares. For how many old shares? For 2 old shares. So the ratio between new to old shares is 5/2. And that is what we are going to write here, 5/2. And that should give us the new number of outstanding shares. Let us find that out on the calculator quickly. 400,000 400,000 times 5/2. And that gives us 1 million new shares. So let us write here 1 million. And that is going to be our new number of shares. What is going to happen to the prices? Now, since the number of shares have increased from 400,000 to 1 million, the price is going to drop in the same proportion. So what we are going to do is we are going to write here the current stock price, that is $50 per share. So let me write here 50, and we are going to simply multiply it by the ratio between old shares to new shares. So that is what we do here. Old shares are 2 and divided by new shares 5. And that should give us the new price per share, and that will be 50 times 2 is 100, and over 5 is going to give us 20. So $20 per share is going to be the new price. You will observe that it does not make any difference whatsoever to the market value of the company's equity, because instead of 400,000 shares, now what we have is 1 million shares. And instead of a $50 per share price, we now have a price of $20 per share, and that keeps the same market value of equity, $20 million, which is the same thing. This one is the same as what we had before. So the market value of the equity does not change because of a stock split. Now if the same thing was to be accomplished through a stock dividend, let me tell you that the difference between the stock split and stock dividend is that stock split is always stated in the form of a ratio, whereas stock dividend is basically the same information but stated in a different format, that is in the format of a percentage. So let us translate this 5-for-2 stock split into percentage terms. And when we do that, what we are going to have with us is the percentage stock dividend. So just like we find out our return, we can find out the percentage of stock dividend. That is the difference between the new and the old. So we write here 5-2, put this inside the bracket and divide this whole thing by the old number of shares, that is 2. And that should give us the percentage of stock dividend. That is going to be 5-2 is a 3, and 3 divided by 2 is 1.5. So we really don't need the calculator here. 1.5, or simply 150%, is the stock dividend in this case. So that is going to mean now what is going to be the new number of shares. So we start as before with the old shares, 400,000, and we are going to multiply this by 1 plus 1.5, and that is going to give us 400,000 times 2.5. Let us see how much does that give us. 400,000 times 2.5, and that gives us again 1 million shares. So let us write here 1 and million. 1 million new number of shares. And what is going to happen to the price? Since the number of shares is increasing, the price per share is supposed to decrease, and it is going to decrease in the same proportion as the increase in the number of shares. So let us write down the old price, which was $50 per share. So let us write here 50. And what we are going to do is we are going to divide this 50 by 1 plus 1.5, that is 2.5. And let us see what we get on the calculator. 50 over 2.5, and that gives us $20. So the new share price is $20 per share, and that is what we had found before with the stock split scenario too. So the market value, you will realize, remains the same, 1 million times $20 per share. So the market value is $20 million, and that is how simple it is to deal with stock splits and stock dividends. Now, as a take-home exercise, what I'm going to ask you to do is to imagine that this stock split was a reverse stock split. That is, for every 5 shares that you hold now, you will now have 2 shares. That is, the number of shares that you will have after the stock split is going to be less than what you had before. So in that scenario, what would be the new number of shares and what would be the price of the share? At the outset, you will understand that the new number of shares is going to be less than 400,000, and the price per share is going to go above $50 per share. Find out that answer, and I hope you will be able to do it. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.